Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another Hearthstone deck presentation video. I'm Fro, and today we are looking at a C'thun Druid deck. Not a Jade Golem Druid deck, but a C'thun Druid deck. And this one is featuring the new legendary from Gadgetzan, it's Kuhn the Forgotten King, that will allow you to either gain 10 armor or refresh your mana crystals. And also we are playing Aviana. So you might know what we are up to. We're playing Aviana on turn 10. Then your minions cost 1, we can play the Kuhn alongside that for 1. We refresh the mana crystals, can play stuff like the C'thun, we can play other minions like the Twin Emperor all for 1 mana then. And we have so much mana left that we should normally hit our opponent heavily in the face. It will be even better if you get Bran on the board as well, so your C'thun will hit double. And that's for a cheap amount of 2 mana, Bran and C'thun. Such a great build. Otherwise, the deck is featuring a lot of Rampier inner weight, double wild growth of course, so you want to get to your 10 mana earlier. You are playing also the Lunar Visions. The original deck list contains 2 Lunar Visions. I currently only have 1, so I've subbed in 1 Living Roots. Otherwise, you can also play 2. You will draw 2 cards, and minions drawn cost 2 less, though it is possible to get your Aviana earlier or to get the C'thun earlier. If you don't have Aviana, then you can just play C'thun and refresh your mana crystals. That might also be helpful. So you could, for example, play the Kuhn and then the C'thun on the same turn, dealing a lot of damage, and also have a strong board with Kuhn and the C'thun on the board, whatever you like there. A bit of destruction here with the Doomsayers early on, so you can prevent the aggressive decks a bit from the Valakim aboard, so it's good against Pirate Warrior and stuff like that. Loot Hoarder to draw more cards, so you can get to your late game cards earlier. And what else? Interesting card, we're also running a Big Game Hunter here that will destroy a minion with 7 or more attack, mostly against the Reno Logs, so you can kill the Mountain Giants easier. Otherwise, you might have problems with that. So let's test the deck out now in some games. It's pretty fun to play, I have played a few rounds of that. Got to my combo quite often, so it is working quite greatly. Now let's head into some games. Let's go. First game, and we are seeing a Pirate Warrior, most likely. In fact, I haven't seen a single Control Warrior on the ladder since Gadgetzan started. Pretty interesting. So we definitely need the Doomsayer here. Let's drop the Bran. Hopefully we can find some ramp as well, so we can maybe find our taunts earlier. But Doomsayer is a must-have here. Oh, got another Doomsayer. Interesting. So we will play Doomsayer on turn 2. We will play Doomsayer on turn 3. Then we have a swipe on turn 4. And a little gap here between our taunt, if we can survive that long. Comes a coin. And a few War Axe. So he's hitting the face with a few War Axe. No minion on the board so far. And we also find the Wild Growth here. It's possible that he's playing Tempo Dragon Warrior, not the Pirate Warrior. We will find out. We will play the Wild Growth then. So we have the potential to play Swipe next turn. But otherwise, I will play Doomsayer and the Hero Power. Get 1 armor. Depends a bit on what he's doing now. There's a Blood Cell Rider, so he is playing the Pirate Warrior. And he's not hitting the face with the weapon now. Which could mean that he has some sort of Blood Cell Cultist in hand and wants to buff the free War Axe. And that means we need to play the swipe here to clear the board from the pirates. So we now need another turn before we can drop the Blood Cell Cultist, if he has a small pirate in hand. Yeah, that's Sir Finlay, searching for a new hero power. If he's getting the Hunter hero power, he might play that this turn. But then he is not able to drop another pirate. So are you hitting us? One with the Fire Blast and the weapon is not hitting, he's still waiting. Pretty sure he has the Blood Cell Cultist in hand. We're definitely now dropping the Doomsayer. And also let's get one more point of armor. Doom the face here. It's currently able to push 5 damage on the Doomsayer. But more should be coming. At 4 he can play, for example, the Cochrane Elite. Apparently he's just hitting the face. So he's losing Sir Finlay. Also had not a very mana efficient turn. 2 mana left. Couldn't play anything. We will now just drop the Dark One here. Nice taunt. And also soon it's getting a bit stronger. Shouldn't really matter how big the C'Thun is, because if we are going to the late game, we should win the game anyway. Mortal Strike. So we're losing the weapon and taking 5 damage, killing the Taunt. The Disciple of C'Thun. Which might or might not be useful right now. Probably not. Guess we will play the Drake and the Loot Order. But let's see first what we draw with the Drake. Lunar Visions. Yeah, then let's drop the Loot Order. Just to get more card draws. Normally the Pirate Warrior is not able to have so many cards on turn 6 in his hand because he has played so much more earlier. Now will you trade? He's trading, right? He is trading, take another 4 points of damage. He is not able to make any pressure at the moment. The C'Thun's chosen. Got the Aviana. We got the Doomsayer. We could play Disciple of C'Thun. Clearing the small time Buccaneer and just dropping the Doomsayer. Then also taking the Hero Power, so back to 25. We would of course lose the Disciple then. Not sure, what can he play? He's not dropping any big stuff currently, so maybe we can keep the Doomsayer. Yeah, in that case, let's drop the Bran. Disciple is killing the small time Buccaneer and we just get another point of armor. So C'Thun is now at 13-13. And with the C'Thun chosen incoming, we will be already at 17-17, which is good enough for him to kill our opponent. Rolling Berserker, Mortal Strike. So he is buffing the Frozen Berserker. We find the Wrath here, which is wonderful. So we're gonna take that out without a problem. Also like to draw 2 more cards now, which might come in handy with the Aviana if we find C'Thun. There you go, that's the C'Thun. So, he is currently at 18. If we use the Disciple of C'Thun, he will be at... he's at 13. He will be at 15. So, that means he's nearly dead then. C'Thun only costs 8 now. We can use the Hero Power. So let's just hit him in the face. Should be the victory next turn. I mean, even if he's getting a Dread Corsair here and can't prevent a bit of damage, he's still losing. He's not playing any execute or stuff like that in the Pirate Warrior. We just have face damage all the time. So 15, that's 16. Yeah, we might get super lucky and win the game right here. But normally that's not the case. And I like to drop the Aviana then alongside. We can play Aviana, the C'Thun. And the game is over. He's at 4. We are still at 21. He can't kill us. And we just hit him next turn with either the Aviana or the C'Thun. And easily win the game. The other conceit. Bye bye, Mr. Pirate. Game 2 against the Shaman. That should also be doable. Definitely keeping the Wild Growth and the Wrath. If we use the Wild Growth on turn 2. I guess we could also keep the C'Thun chosen. Yeah, let's do that. Keeping the C'Thun chosen. And the Dark One, or Small Taunt. I really want to see the Disciple of C'Thun here. So we can play that on turn 2. That might be the best curve we could get. So starting with the Wild Growth, then playing the Disciple, then the C'Thun chosen. That's a swipe. Maybe we can find the Disciple. Maybe, maybe. With the Wild Growth, we are going to 3 next turn. Hasn't played anything on turn 1, so no Tunnel Talk for him, no Spirit Claws as a Totem Golem, which we can easily kill with a swipe here. We can use the C'Thun chosen, drop that on the board and trade into the 3-4. Doesn't make much sense here to drop the Bran. We might want to play that later with the C'Thun. Ooh, double Totem Golem. That's a nice start for him. So let's try the C'Thun's chosen here and see if he's able to handle that. I mean, he shouldn't be able to kill that without losing one Totem Golem. But there's a Maelstrom Portal. Do you also have a Lightning Bolt? Nah, he hasn't. So he's losing one Totem Golem. And we also find the Living Roots here. So that would be good enough to clear the whole board, but not sure if I want to use that on the Hungry Crab. That's really not that dangerous. Could get the Zaplings as well here on the board, but if he has another Maelstrom Portal, he would just clear them, so that might be a waste then. So let's just pass. Happily taking the 1 point here. Oh, White Eyes. Are you playing some sort of control, Shaman? Possible. Stop the drop our taunt here. Good enough for the 5-5 and the 1-1. C'Thun is now at 11-11. Jade Lightning. Oh, oh. And the Jade Claws. So he's not losing the White Eyes. That was bad. Big Game Hunter. Gonna kill that. And are we keeping the Jade Golem here at the 2-2 on the board? Or are we killing that? Draw another card here, which might be useful. Let's do that. We're taking 1 point of damage here. There's a Doomsayer. That is interesting. So we have 3 cards on his hand, currently able to push 5 damage. I mean, he could. He hasn't played Lightning Bolt earlier, so the chance of him to have that is rather slim. And if he wants to use a Lightning Storm on the Doomsayer, fine with that. I mean, he still can use a Flame Tongue Totem, that would be enough to clear the Doomsayer, but even then we are preventing the damage that is not hitting the face, and we can just kill the Jade Golem next turn. Visiting the face normally means he's not able to clear the Doomsayer, and there you go, saved us. Got that inner weight, so definitely drawing now with the Nourish. There's Aviana, and there's the C'Thun. Ooh, the C'Thun currently at 11-11. We will drop the Aviana, we will drop the C'Thun and the Bran Bronzebeard. That is working out because we have the inner weight, so we can play Aviana for 9. Then we need 2 more mana, so Bran and C'Thun. That is doable. And right now he has an exactly 22 life. We are pushing 22 with the C'Thun. So a win is possible next turn. He will of course drop a few minions. Yeah, Storm Guardian. That is nice for you. So let's see. We also have the Big Game Hunter. We are not able to kill him right now. So it might be better to drop the Big Game Hunter and the Disciple of C'Thun.
I've got the beast in my
which allows us to clear the board, buffing the C'Thun a bit further. So he's at 13-13 and we're dealing 26 damage next turn. Which is even better. Also we can draw two cards then with the Drake. If we are not able to kill him here. But he's taking more damage. Look at that, down to 18. Yeah, that's it, right? That is a bit more, okay. Then it is not. And we need to wait another turn. But we should clear everything on the board. At least I hope so. C'Thun shows, and that will buff the C'Thun up to 17-17. That should be enough. Okay, let's do that. So it is Aviana, dropping the Bran. Play the Inner Weight. You play the C'Thun Chosen. C'Thun will be at 17-17. And let's go. So there you go. Hitting, hitting, hitting. And he's down. Just like that. Nice combo. Our third and last game for today is also against the Shaman. As we have seen in the last game, that is definitely winnable. Starting end is not so hot, so we replace all three cards here. Definitely looking for some early ramp. Or Doomsayer, that's also nice. Getting knowledge and the swipe. No ramp. Well, we could use the knowledge for some ramp, but normally we need the card loss. Otherwise we are not getting to our combo. Not dropping a minion. In that case, I like to keep the Doomsayer one more turn. We might see a Totem Golem now. Otherwise, he will just use the Totem Hero Power. Yeah, there you go. Shade Claws. No Totem Golem. And we find the Disciple here, which would be good enough to take out the Jade Golem and also buff our C'Thun. He could then kill that with the weapon, losing one durability there and taking two damage. Really don't want to drop the Doomsayer here for the 1-1. Comes a coin. And this Bran Bronzebeard. So, he is at 3 right now. Next turn he will be at 4. Means he's able to play the Jade Spirits. And I really don't want to give him 2 Jade Golems on the board. So, Swipe is coming. It's pretty obvious what he's doing here. There's the Jade Spirit. Getting a 2-2. That means he currently has 6 damage on the board. The Doomsayer is 7 life. So we might keep that alive. Definitely using the Wild Growth here. And we're trying the Doomsayer. Chance is slim that he's surviving. But there is a chance. Yeah, not happening. Jade Lightning, 3-3 Golem on the board. Trady trade. But at least we're not getting any sort of damage here. There's a swipe, which we could use now. Also wait a bit longer. We could drop the Drake here with the Wrath, clearing the 2-2. Then he needs to trade. Could potentially keep the 3-3 on the board, which would be a target for the swipe. Let's do that. Draw another card. Found already the C'Thun. Only an 8-8 with the Dark Aruka. That is an 11-11 then. Still a bit to go. But we're coming there. That's the Bran. So doubling the amount of damage we could push if we get the Aviana. Well, another Jade Spirit. That's quite a lot of Jade Golem action early on. Definitely a bit too much for my taste. Taking the first points of damage here, down to 28. So we still have a lot to go. That's Coon, which allows us to play Coon and the C'Thun in one turn. Not able currently to play also the Bran because we still need the Aviana. So let's drop the taunt and just get the hero power hitting him for one. We probably play the Norwich next turn and the swipe. So with the Norwich drawing three more cards, hopefully finding Aviana. Chances there with then 17 cards left. And the next Jade Golem is already coming. That is really a lot. There's Aviana. So we are able to drop the combo next turn. Means we only need to look up here a bit that we're not taking too much damage. We could clear the 5/5 Jade Golem here if we use the swipe and the hero power. We could also just clear the Jade Spirit, but then he is just healing back with the healing totem. So we don't need the Norwich right now. We'll play Aviana, Coon, the Bran and the C'Thun next turn. So the C'Thun would deal 22 damage, which is definitely good enough to clear the board. And I really like to kill the Jade Golem here. Let's hope that he's not dropping too many big creatures now. Yeah, just like that. So there's a high chance that one or two creatures can survive here, maybe even three. They have a very big body. And we are currently at 16. So if all three survives here, he just wins the game. Which would be pretty sucky. He got nearly all of his Jade Golem cards set early. Still 18 cards left and he has nearly played it all. Only missing the Arya Blackpaw. So let's try. Still gonna try it. And we might find even a bit of help here with the Drake, or we can buff the C'Thun a bit longer and draw two cards. They have the Disciple and the Doomsayer. So with the Disciple, I like to hit the 6/6 here. The C'Thun is now 15/15, we can deal 13 damage. Might be even draw three more cards. Might find another C'Thun card. Go, 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 go. No, not the case. So C'Thun it is. And let's also drop the Loot Hoarder. So we are clearing the whole board, okay. That should be it. Down to 7. We have a full board, he can't clear that. And he can't push 16 damage. And again, the combo was worth it. There you go, we win that. So really like the deck, you should check it out, definitely guys. I'm currently 5-0 with the deck. So try it out and see how you can perform with the deck on the ladder. If you have enjoyed the video, don't forget to give me a like and subscribe to my channel. That would be wonderful and would help my content to grow. See you in the next video, will come tomorrow or today, let's see, and have a good night, bye bye.